My name is Hanson, first name Sid. 2 weeks ago, I was a successful Beverly Hills plastic surgeon.
Veronica Booker wants you to know she loves her new breast.
I grew up in Providence, Rhode Island. God only knows it would take my sister's wedding for me to go back home and face my close-knit family. That was before my mom died during the ceremony. It hit me hard. I realized you can never escape where you're from. So I moved back home, just in time for a miracle. Yes. And the opportunity to redirect my career into family practice. Back where I never thought I'd be. Providence. Since I moved back home from LA, I picked up an old high school habit before bed, my journal. Back then, it was just an excuse to ruminate on boys, or grown men, as they're now called. Though most of the guys I dated in LA definitely fell into the former category. When I remember Jerry and our life in Malibu, I wonder what planet I was on. But then I think about Kyle. He may not pull down six figures or wear power ties, but he's something I never encountered in LA. A real man, 100% grade A guy, a T-bone amongst the mixed vegetable plates. And it's not just physical.
Oh, give me a break.
It's true, Mother.
Oh, poppycock. Name me his three best qualities and his buns only count as one.
Okay. He's kind and thoughtful and even the slightest bit unpredictable. See?
Don't open it, I warn you.
What are you talking about?
Providence is a small town. You start tearing up the sheets with some limo driver and word will spread like cheap perfume.
I don't care.
Tell me that when you wind up pregnant and abandoned like your sister.
Joni is perfectly capable of making her own choices. And so am I.
Trust me, this is your hormones talking.
Out of my way, Mother, I'm letting him in.
No, I'll do it. Go back to bed. Go on. At least try and appear a little less desperate. Hi, Kyle.
Mrs. Hanson.
Bye, oh! Kyle.
Mother! How could you do that?
That's my job these days, darling. Saving you from yourself. Sweet dreams.
Morning, girls.
Morning. How'd you sleep?
Only got up once. Thought I heard Melvin, the Persian, howling downstairs.
Oh, no, that was Sid having an erotic dream about Kyle.
Joni?
It's okay, Sid. You're not in high school anymore. Heck, you're even allowed to have boys in your room.
Hey, that go for me, too?
Yeah.
Only kidding. I prefer the Highlight Motel down on Route 32. Now, that's a place you can make some noise. Later.
Sid, you busy tonight?
Not that I know of. Why?
Well, I thought I could take advantage of the fact that you're home and maybe pick up on one of our old high school rituals.
You want to quiz me on my vocab for SATs?
How about chocolate sundaes at McDear's?
Sure, sounds great. Hey, Dad. Is there something else on your mind?
It can wait till tonight.
Hi, I'm Dr. Hansen.
Hi.
So, Dana McGuire. It's a pretty name. Does your family own a bakery on Federal Hill?
My family doesn't own anything. Why do you think I'm at a free clinic?
Well, just because you're at a clinic doesn't mean you're getting substandard care. What do your parents do?
My dad's not around. My mom moved up to Nova Scotia for a job. I stay with my aunt so I can finish my senior year.
South Providence?
Where else?
So you had some shortness of breath, and I see that you're taking your medication for asthma. Has the albuterol been helping?
Not as much as before.
Just take a breath for me. Again? Let's take care of that wheezing for you, okay? Annika, I need her on a pulse ox monitor, 0.5 albuterol by handheld nebulizer.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Let's go.
Mr. Linkletter just called, wants to know when he can pick up Flops.
Tell him it was only a water cyst, but I'd like to keep him overnight just to make sure he's okay.
You have a new patient waiting. A Miss Maravich.
Recommended by?
The Yellow Pages.
Huh. Miss Maravich?
Yes.
Hi, I'm Dr. Hansen.
Hi.
Oh, what a beautiful bulldog.
Dutch Buster.
Hi, Buster. How are you?
He belonged to my father, who recently passed away.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Thank you. I'm a little worried about him. Since then, he spends most of his time in Dad's bed and...
Is he eating?
A little.
Drinking?
Not much. In fact, I wonder if that's not the problem.
What do you mean?
I'm a little embarrassed to say this, but my father always had a few beers after dinner, and he got in the habit of...
Sharing his habit?
I'm afraid so.
Oh, don't be. I once had an owner who spent every Sunday preparing a pot roast for her chocolate lab, and then topped it off with a bottle of her best burgundy.
Tell you what, I'd like to keep Buster here with me for a few hours, if that's all right with you. Run some tests. I'll call you if I find anything.
Okay.
What do you think, Buster? Would you like to hang around with me for a few hours?
I think you remind him of my father. Oh, a younger version, that is.
Our Town, that's one of my favorite plays. You doing it in school? Providence Players?
How'd you know?
I was a member of my sophomore and junior year. Is Miss Lyons still there?
Yeah.
Take a breath. Actually, she was very influential in my life. Another breath. After watching me act for 2 years, she suggested I consider medicine. Well, when I did it in 83, I played Mrs. Gibbs. What part are you playing?
Emily.
The lead. Well, that settles it. I've got the star of the show in my care. I've got no choice but to make you better.
Ah, that's a mighty handsome squirrel you got there.
It's not a squirrel. It's a ferret.
I was just testing. What's his name?
Alonzo.
Alonzo? It's a beauty. You just get him?
Oh, I've had him here ever since I came to school. Here you go.
Oh, let me get that for you. Thank you very much. You know, I think it's fantastic that you take him for cappuccino. I mean, not every pet owner is that considerate.
Oh, I'm taking him to the vet.
Really? It's nothing too serious, I hope.
Well, he's been limping.
Well, that could be anything from a knee burn to a torn ACL. Is he having any trouble going to his left? Is he getting less elevation on his jumper? Who's your vet?
I got his name off the college bulletin board. Dr. Atkinson?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Tom Atkinson over on Benefit.
Yeah, you know him?
Yeah, sure. My dad's a vet, you know, so they were close friends. Wow, that's great. I'm really glad to see that Tom's back in business.
Back? What do you mean?
Well, he had some personal problems. But who doesn't, right?
What kind of personal problems?
I probably shouldn't say. I mean, we adore Tom, but nobody really wants to see any more innocent animals come to any harm.
Sorry to show up here unannounced, but I was in the neighborhood.
You were?
No, I was clear on the other side of town, headed in a different direction. The truth is, I've been thinking about you, and this is a little embarrassing.
Well, don't worry. Can't scare me with the old naked truth bit.
Last night, I had a dream about you.
Didn't involve a ladder, did it? No, never mind.
I dreamt we were having lunch.
What's so embarrassing about that?
Okay. It was sex.
Was I good?
You were great. Listen, I was hoping we could grab a real lunch.
I'd love to, but this place is so jammed, I'd be lucky to find 10 minutes.
Exactly the time it takes to wolf down a sandwich.
Under ordinary circumstances, you've made me a sandwich I couldn't refuse.
But not today. Okay. What about tonight?
That sounds good.
Pick you up at 8.
Great.
All right. It's okay, Buster. It's okay. I know, pal. I know.
There you go.
Child needs to get out more.
Don't we all?
Why don't you take her for a walk? I can hold down the fort here. And while you're out, why don't you stop at Hare Hands and get me a bottle of beer, will you?
Okay. Come on.
It's okay, sweetie. It's okay.
Robbie, what brings you to these parts? Bank of Dad is presently occupied.
Ye of little faith. You know, I happen to be here on a humanitarian mission.
Oh, let me guess. Some bimbo you met at the bar's got a sick chinchilla.
Wrong again, sis. Happens to be a ferret.
Oh, Buster. I understand what you're going through. There's nothing worse than losing a lifelong companion. You grow together like vines. And when one dies, you're suddenly out there on the wall all alone. I'm afraid this is one of those times when a doctor feels pretty helpless.
Dad?
Robbie, what are you doing here?
A friend of mine's got a gimpy ferret. His name's Alonzo.
The friend or the ferret?
The little guy. Would you take a look at him?
Sure.
I'd stick around, but I gotta get to work.
I understand.
Hey, Dad.
Hmm?
Everything all right?
Yeah, everything is just fine. Everything's just fine.
What's up?
Sorry to call you out of work. I think there's something weird going on with Dad.
Why? What makes you say that?
I stopped by his office this morning. I caught him talking to a bulldog.
That's not so unusual. Dad talks to his patients all the time.
He does.
Yeah. The owners love it, and the animals understand every word. Some of them even talk back to him.
Sid, seriously, I got that strange dad vibe, like the time he was thinking of moving us all to Alaska.
When was that?
You were in college, right? I found all these real estate brochures in his desk. It was a done deal. He was just waiting for the right time to break it to Mom.
You know, he did say he wanted to talk to me this morning, but he didn't say what it was about.
Well, if you hear the word Eskimo, hit the brakes, would you? Now that Mom's not around, we all gotta take a hard line on this one, okay?
I promise, Robbie, we won't step foot past North Providence.
See ya.
Bye.
Dad, I got your beer.
Put some in a bowl for him, will you?
What do you expect us to do?
Hopefully remind him of the old days. He's got a very weak heart. Come on, Buster. You've got to want to live.
Is he gonna be all right?
Feeling any better?
Not really.
So how long have you been interested in theater?
Ever since I can remember. I'm hoping to major in drama in college next year.
Where do you want to go to school?
UCLA. It's my first choice.
It's a wonderful school. Taught a class there last year.
You worked in Los Angeles?
Breathe. Yep, until a short time ago.
I've never been to California, but here they have great sunsets.
They say it's the smog.
Oh.
Well, that's only said by the people who don't have such great sunsets. Another breath. We had some doozies in Malibu.
You lived in Malibu? God, that must have been so awesome.
Actually, it was extremely awesome. You know, when I was your age, I dreamed about going to California, too. I bought every book I could find on the state. Don't have much use for those anymore. Would you like to have them?
Sure.
How we doing?
She's still wheezing, so I want you to repeat the albuterol nebulizer, give her 125 milligrams of IV solumedrol, and I need a chest x-ray.
Okay. There you are. Ms. Maravich is here. You want me to break it to her?
Of course not. I've done this for over 30 years. Please send her in.
Hi.
Ms. Maravich.
Oh, Polly, please.
Polly, please sit down.
Where's Buster?
Buster had a very weak heart, and I'm afraid that without your father, he didn't have the will.
Buster passed away.
Buster passed away. Sorry, I saw it coming, and I did everything I could.
Oh, Doctor, it's not your fault. I'm sure you did your very best.
I'm sorry, Buster was a very sweet dog, and... Excuse me. I'm sorry.
Okay, Mr. C, here's the deal. Cut it down to 3 cigars a day, and we're still on speaking terms. Cut it down to 1 cigar a day, and I'll fix you up with Annika. I have Miss McGuire's chest x-ray and lab results back.
How does it look?
Not good. Her H&H is 10 and 28. Looks like a widened mediastinum. This girl needs to go to the hospital.
Whoa, wait a minute. Why would she have that?
Well, by the length of her fingers and the asthma, could be Marfan's.
Dana's pulse ox is down to 90.
Call 911. She's getting cyanotic.
I'll get her head.
BP's 80 over 50. There's a holosystolic murmur that wasn't there before.
Mitral regurge?
I think it's aortic dissection. Annika, get her on a monitor. Start a large bore IV, saline wide open.
Done.
Raouf, get a crash cart in here fast.
Right.
Get her on 10 liters by mask.
10 liters by mask.
Ooh. She's out. There's no breath on the left side.
Maybe pneumothorax?
We have a chest tube tray?
O2's at 10 liters.
We'll have to improvise.
All we got is a 36 French.
Nothing smaller?
It'll have to do.
Here you
She's
go.
She's gradient down, rate's 40.
Chest tube.
Pressure's still growing.
You You got O2.
Saline's on board.
Her chest is full of blood. Her aorta must have ruptured.
No pulse.
I'll start CPR. She needs blood.
It's gloves. A clinic, Sid. There's no blood bank.
All right, is there a rapid infuser for the saline?
No, I'll squeeze it in.
All right, that's it. Bagger. I need to intubate.
Go.
I need a 7.5 ET.
All right, 7.5.
Let's go.
Okay, let's move.
How's it look? It's going.
More saline scanning. Our best shot is to crack open her chest. Maybe I can control the hemorrhaging.
No, not here. Paramedics are en route. We need to get her to the ER.
She'll never make it to the hospital.
You're not a vascular surgeon.
Look, I could give you a rundown of my surgical credentials, but she'll be dead by then.
Still no pulse.
Let's do it.
All right, Draper. Is there a thoracotomy tray?
It's a clinic, Sid.
Give me a 10 blade.
It's prepped.
Another sterile container.
There's another box of 4x4s.
I've got suction.
Her aorta's ruptured, all right. Her chest is full of blood.
Come on, suction.
I've got suction.
AVD pad.
I've got one.
Okay, subtraction on the ribs.
Anna can get over here.
All right, where the hell is it? Okay, I feel it. Aortic clamp.
Will a Kelly work?
No.
Can you tampon off with your finger?
Let's hope so.
Double pressure.
Okay, I got it.
Go ahead, do that area again.
Peg another two of saline.
Start a second line.
We've got a rhythm. Is there a pulse?
Think carotid.
I'll take anything.
The cavalry's here.
Thank God.
Four, please call extension 6611. Dr. LaFour, please call extension 6611.
Dr. Hansen?
Yes.
I'm Dr. Kurtz. I was able to sew in a graft on your patient. She's looking good.
Great. Thanks.
Thank you. That was a gutsy thing you did. In a family clinic, no less.
Believe me, it wasn't my first choice. But I just didn't think she was going to make it.
She wouldn't have without you. Are you all right?
Fine. Why?
It's just that sometimes after one of these adrenalized emergencies, you can have a tendency to crash.
How many sleepovers do we have tonight?
Let's see. Rufus, Bobo, Barney, Gladys, and Floyd. 5. Oh, and Flops.
Call my 4 o'clocks and move them to tomorrow. I'm calling it a day.
You are?
Is that a problem?
Hey, I'm not complaining. I can still catch general trauma.
I don't know why you waste your time with those soap operas.
I can put all the hours together and then within 5 years have a degree in dental hygiene.
Dr. Hansen, we heard. She made it.
Congratulations, Dr. Hansen.
The Providence Journal called. A guy wants to interview you.
Oh, Patrice, can you handle that for me? Just tell him it was a group effort, okay?
Dr. Hansen, can I have a word with you in private?
I hate to drag you away from your fan club, but as head of this clinic, I'm claiming special privilege.
I was saving this for the Nobel Prize ceremony, but you deserve it.
Oh. Helen, for the first time since I moved back to Providence, just felt so right.
Like you were sent back to save that girl?
Yeah.
If only life were that neat.
What does that mean?
Well, your big dream was to go to California to become a plastic surgeon. Now you're in Providence doing family medicine.
Go figure.
Guess we can't control the future. Mm. But we can certainly celebrate moments. And in the spirit of this moment, to the ballsiest surgeon this side of the Narragansett.
Yeah, right.
Oh, Dr. Newman, I'm so glad you came.
Cassandra, we need to talk about your condition. I have some bad news. I'm afraid the heart that was intended for you was stolen in transit.
Oh. I'm afraid, Doctor, that that's not the only heart that's been stolen.
Cassandra, you don't know what you're saying. You're in a weak and vulnerable condition.
No, Doctor. I've felt this way ever since the first time you examined me. When you touched my bare shoulders with those wonderful hands, I nearly fainted.
Oh, my God. Dr. Philip Newman.
Actually, that's just a part I play.
I'm watching you right now. You're telling Cassandra about her hijacked heart.
I'm looking for Dr. Sidney Hansen.
She's my sister.
She's my doctor.
I can't believe she failed to tell me that.
Is she in by any chance?
No, but I'll find her. For you.
Eventually.
Here, come on in. What, you want to come in?
Yes.
Yeah.
No, I'm sorry, I can't promise you the back room. But I do keep a special preferred list, and you sound like fabulous people. Yep, handsome. Robbie, just see me when you get here. Okay, bye.
Hey, Dad. How you doing? What brings you down?
Ferret Express.
Oh, how is he?
I had to put a little splint on his right leg, but he should be okay in a week or so.
No more pickup games for you, Alonzo. So, how much do I owe you?
It's on the house.
Well, at least let me reciprocate. I know you don't drink, but how about a nice iced tea?
How about a double scotch?
Okay.
More coffee?
No, thanks. It's getting late. I should be getting back to the Biltmore. If you could just tell your sister.
I bet that's her. No, don't go anywhere. Sid.
Hey, it's me.
Robbie.
Joni, I don't mean to alarm you, but Dad's with me.
Why would that alarm me?
Well, he's had a few drinks. I don't think he should drive.
So make up an excuse and drive him home.
What kind of an excuse?
Robbie, you con the man out of several thousand dollars a year. I'm sure you can come up with something.
Hey, how you doing, Dad? You want a cup of coffee?
No, thanks. I'll just finish this.
Hey, Robbie, I've got a message here for you.
Thanks, Tom. Excuse me, Dad. I just, little business. I'll be right back. Cindy, hi. Great news about Alonzo. Everything's gonna be fine.
Oh, that's so wonderful.
Yeah, well, you know how I feel about animals.
This is so incredibly kind of you to go out of your way like this.
And I don't want to hear word one about money, okay? This one's on me.
I don't know how to thank you.
I'm sure we'll figure something out. He's in my office. Come on.
Hey, Robbie, your dad said to thank you for the drinks.
He didn't leave, did he?
Yeah, I just walked out.
Tom, do me a favor. Would you take Cindy back to my office? I'll be right back, okay?
Emergency.
You couldn't call?
Sorry, Joni. It was one of those little life or death things. I mean, why, what's up?
Dr. Philip Newman was here in the living room waiting for you.
Who the hell is Dr. Philip Newman?
General trauma? Ring a bell? Bo Tucker.
Bo Tucker's in Providence?
In the flesh. He needs you to check up on his eye job.
Great. More importantly, how is Dad? Robbie said that he wasn't feeling very good, kind of down.
Not anymore. He went over to O'Neill's and got hammered. Well, that's nice of you to be concerned.
What's that supposed to mean?
You live in your own world, Sid. It never occurs to you that maybe other members of your family might have emotional needs.
Is this about you or Dad?
Both. You probably think it's pathetic that I get so excited over meeting some soap star. But we all can't have your glamorous life.
Oh, look, Joni, before I glamorously collapse from exhaustion onto the couch, could you just give me an update on Dad?
Don't worry, Robbie's bringing him home. He's just fine. There, that's probably them now.
Kyle.
You didn't remember, did you?
Oh, my God. Our date.
You were looking forward to it that much?
I'm sorry. I had an emergency operation, and then I got home to a sister with a bad case of attitude.
Families, you can't live with them, you can't live without them.
Ain't it the truth?
So, what do you say we,
Kyle.
We postpone it to another night.
Would you mind?
We've waited this long. I think I can last another week.
Wow.
Sid. Sid. I just wanted to apologize for being such a bitch earlier. I'd say you were the best big sister in the whole world, but you're more than a big sister. You're a saint.
She's right, you know.
Kyle.
I left here tonight thinking I could wait a week for you, but I couldn't wait a night.
Oh, Kyle. Oh, Kyle.
God, you're the most amazing woman I have ever met.
Oh, enough already. One more testimonial and we'll be building a bloody shrine. Can't you see they're just telling you what you want to hear?
Your mother again? I thought she was dead.
She is, she is. She just occasionally pops into my dreams to criticize the living. Look, it's like a dysfunctional version of our town.
Honey, you don't really expect this boy to understand a classic literary reference like that?
I saw Our Town in high school. Sid was in it.
Nothing personal, Kyle. You're very hunky. Even dead, I get that. But after a few sweaty nights, where does it all lead?
Maybe I should leave.
No. Oh, no. No, she should leave. It's my dream, damn it. Get out.
Sid, let him go. This is no time for petty lust. Not with your father in the state that he's in.
Oh, Dad is fine. I'm sure he's fine.
You don't really believe that, or you wouldn't be having this dream. It's 3 a.m. Do you know where your father is?
Sid. Sid, wake up.
Did I get back?
I don't know. I got up to feed Hannah. I heard a really strange sound coming from his room. Come on.
Wait, coming.
That is not his snore.
How can you tell?
Because I've been sleeping across the hall for the past 25 years.
It's time to roll out of bed and start your day. The weather looks good this morning. We'll see some in and out clouds and sun for a while.
Good morning.
With some terrific outdoor weather for much of the weekend. The next storm potential.
You heard from Dad?
Not a peep. Here he comes. Should we say anything?
No.
Yes. No.
Any sign of Dad?
I thought you were bringing him home.
Well, he blew out of the bar. I followed him for a couple hours, but I lost him.
Lost him?
Yeah, I was gonna come back here and tell you guys, but I had to see a friend with a lame ferret.
What?
Anyway, came back here around 3, fell asleep at the dead.
Well, Dad must have come home in the middle of the night. We found him conked out with the petting zoo.
You know what? I think he's going through some sort of crisis.
Duh. Maybe we shouldn't let him out of our sight for the next few days.
What are we gonna do, put a bell around his neck?
Good morning, everybody.
Hi, Dad.
Come on.
Excuse me, nurse. Are you a relative?
I'm Dr. Hansen from the clinic.
Oh, hero of the hour. I was just telling Dana if it wasn't for you, we probably wouldn't be taking her breakfast order.
Does she have any family here?
Her aunt just left for work. I'll give you guys a minute alone.
Thanks.
I just wanted to let you know that we're gonna do our damnedest to have you on stage in time for opening night. And I didn't forget about the California books. I'll bring those by later. Until then, keep thinking Golden State.
Excuse me, nurse.
You just mean one second.
Dr. Newman.
Oh, my God.
Dr. Newman, excuse me.
Yes?
My new hip is acting up. Maybe you'd give it a look.
Bo? What are you doing here?
Well, I was on my way to Boston for a promotion. Thought I'd stop by, have the baby Browns checked.
Why don't you have a seat?
What's the matter? Something wrong?
I could do some tests, but it looks like a textbook case.
Of what?
Lying eyes. Come on, you didn't come 3,000 miles to get your eyes checked. This has something to do with my ex-boyfriend, your current agent, doesn't it?
Oh, Jerry's lost without you, Sid. He even gave up the cigar club.
Ouch.
I don't expect you to call, but maybe you could write.
Write? Write?
Yeah.
I caught him with a man in our shower.
And that's a reason to stop communicating? You can write him a nice letter.
Forget it.
A card, then. Maybe one of those silly pop-up jobs. I'm desperate, Sid. He's not the same agent. He's not getting me out like he used to. I'll do anything.
Anything? Bo, hello.
Joni, isn't it?
Yeah, Joni. Joan? Janice, really. Whatever you like.
Well, I have a couple of hours before my flight, and, Sid said you might be willing to show me Providence.
Sid said that.
Yeah, was she wrong?
No. I'd love to. Let me just go, check with my dad, okay?
You're not underage, are you?
No. Oh, I work for him. You were making a joke. How flattering. Oh, my God.
I heard the news about the young girl you saved.
Word travels fast.
Small town. A friend of mine, Pete Zeegan, was on the surgical team. He said you did a magnificent job.
I never thought she was going to make it, Dad.
I know the feeling.
Joni told me about the bulldog. I'm sorry.
Listen, if you got the time, maybe we could hit McDear's.
I just have to stop by the hospital first and drop off the books.
I'll drive you over. We can go from there.
Deal. Nurse?
Dr. Hansen.
I was just looking for Dana. She doesn't seem to be in her room.
No one told you?
Tell me what?
The graft leaked. They had to take her back into the OR.
When?
This afternoon.
Is she still in recovery?
No. She didn't make it.
Close the door and leave the world behind you. Open the window and listen to the breeze blow through the pines. Take a deep breath. What more can you do?
Yet I was so invested
in
myself. Dad, I have been so wrapped up trying to be a hero that I've been oblivious to what you're going through. What happened yesterday?
I woke up, looked at the ring on my finger, and realized I was no longer a married man. that the woman with whom I had spent the best part of a very good life was gone.
And that I didn't want to deal with it. Hadn't been to your mother's grave since she passed. I went there last night because I wanted to give her back my ring. But I lost my nerve. So I just sat there outside the gates, couldn't bring myself to go in.
I know you probably want to do that by yourself. But if you change your mind, difference a day makes. Yesterday, I felt like a savior. But tonight, as I watched Dad at Mom's grave, I was aware that I could do nothing for his pain. As a doctor and a daughter, I don't think I ever felt more powerless. 'Cause your eyes on the ocean, 'cause your soul in the sea. My dark night seems endless. Please remember me. Please remember me. Please remember
me. Can't sleep?
Technically, I am asleep, aren't I?
Yes, but you're having psychic insomnia. The kind of sleep where you wake up in the morning exhausted. I'm at least happy to see that the chauffeur isn't climbing through the window again.
Well, romance is the last thing on my mind.
Death does put a damper on things. Though I really don't know why. You and your father put entirely too much stock on saving people's lives.
We are doctors, Mother.
Oh, that's just a fancy name for mechanics. You get a whole new perspective when you're dead.
Oh, I can hardly wait.
Don't be so melodramatic. You lost a patient, but you were there for your father.
Are you kidding? The last few days, the man's been overcome with grief, and I shut up for the ice cream.
Better late than never. Watching the two of you tonight at my grave almost made me want to be alive again.
Really?
Absolutely. You've got a big day tomorrow.
Do you know something you're not telling me?
They're all big days. At least they should be. Now go to sleep.
Maybe you could stay a while.
No, dear. I've got some very urgent business to attend.
What's that?
I have to help a certain bulldog find his man. Say goodnight, Buster.
In a meeting.